Not a life, but a torment. Scientists found out how loneliness kills, according to Professor John Cacioppo of the University of Chicago. The excruciating feeling of loneliness is a kind of adaptation mechanism that has evolved in the course of human evolution. As social animals, in prehistoric times humans fended for themselves and foraged for food together. Excluding an individual from the group was tantamount to a death sentence. The individual died from starvation or predators. Therefore, the feeling of loneliness that compels us to seek the company of our own kind is analogous to, for example, the feeling of hunger that compels an animal to go hunting. Studying for several decades people with socialization difficulties, Cacioppo found that most of their physiological disturbances were related to the sympathetic nervous system, the one responsible for the freeze or run reaction when faced with a predator. Apparently, the human body considers the feeling of loneliness a danger and regards it as a warning signal. The discomfort of being alone for a long time, together with the negative physiological response, it is proved that lonely elderly people are more prone to infectious diseases than their more sociable peers, were a useful acquisition in prehistoric times, when humans had to survive among the hostile nature. But in modern society it is of no use, even the opposite. Loneliness can lead to premature death due to constant internal stress. How loneliness kills. Researchers from York University and Newcastle University found that loneliness and social isolation increase the risk of cardiovascular disease by a third. An analysis of 23 studies involving a total of 180,000 volunteers found that low levels of social interaction increase the likelihood of coronary heart disease attacks by 29% and stroke by 32%. People who communicate little with friends and relatives and never married, in old age are more likely to suffer dementia, say British researchers. Convinced bachelors' risk of this disease after 65 years is 42% higher than those who were married or had a steady partner for several years. Also, singles have a 15% higher mortality rate from cancer. Probably the same mechanism that works in gray rats, the production of a number of important hormones in the body of animals kept in separate cells without congeners is disrupted, resulting in cancerous tumors. Elderly people who live alone and do not maintain relationships with friends and relatives, die earlier, and because the loneliness and the stress associated with it affects the work of the immune system cells, according to American doctors. White blood cells of singles are more prone to inflammation and less responsive to viruses. Moreover, this effect intensifies with time. The longer the loneliness, the more pronounced these disorders are. It's contagious. Scientists from Brigham Young University predict that in the coming years, humanity is waiting for a veritable epidemic of loneliness. And in the risk group of young people, for whom the probability of premature death from stress associated with social isolation, much higher than for the elderly. The authors of the work note that people who live in families and have many friends are increasingly feeling lonely. According to John Cacioppo, this may be due to the fact that loneliness, like many other social phenomena, such as smoking, is a kind of contagious disease. Having analyzed with colleagues social connections in the American town of Framingham, the scientist came to the conclusion that lonely people prefer to communicate with their peers, which means that loneliness is a manifestation of copycat behavior. Statistics, based on data collected over 50 years, confirm this. Those who socialize with lonely people eventually begin to suffer from loneliness as well. The dangers of social isolation and its effects on health are greatly underestimated, University of Queensland researchers say. Only 15% of US and British citizens surveyed by scientists admitted that loneliness may be a significant factor in premature death. Meanwhile, according to experts from the University of Minnesota, loneliness kills more people a year than smoking, alcohol, and obesity. Not a life, but a torment. Scientists found out how loneliness kills, according to Professor John Cacioppo of the University of Chicago. The excruciating feeling of loneliness is a kind of adaptation mechanism that has evolved in the course of human evolution. As social animals, in prehistoric times humans fended for themselves and foraged for food together. Excluding an individual from the group was tantamount to a death sentence, the individual died from starvation or predators. Therefore, the feeling of loneliness that compels us to seek the company of our own kind is analogous to, for example, the feeling of hunger that compels an animal to go hunting. Studying for several decades people with socialization difficulties, Cacioppo found that most of their physiological disturbances were related to the sympathetic nervous system, the one responsible for the freeze or run reaction when faced with a predator. Apparently, the human body considers the feeling of loneliness a danger and regards it as a warning signal. The discomfort of being alone for a long time, together with the negative physiological response, it is proved that lonely elderly people are more prone to infectious diseases than their more sociable peers, were a useful acquisition in prehistoric times, when humans had to survive among the hostile nature. But in modern society it is of no use, even the opposite, loneliness can lead to premature death due to constant internal stress. How loneliness kills. Researchers from York University and Newcastle University found that loneliness and social isolation increase the risk of cardiovascular disease by a third. An analysis of 23 studies involving a total of 180,000 volunteers found that low levels of social interaction increased the likelihood of coronary heart disease attacks by 29% and stroke by 32%. People who communicate little with friends and relatives and never married, in old age are more likely to suffer dementia, say British researchers. Convinced bachelors' risk of this disease after 65 years is 42% higher than those who were married or had a steady partner for several years. Also, singles have a 15% higher mortality rate from cancer. Probably the same mechanism that works in gray rats, the production of a number of important hormones in the body of animals kept in separate cells without congeners is disrupted, resulting in cancerous tumors. Elderly people who live alone and do not maintain relationships with friends and relatives, die earlier, and because the loneliness and the stress associated with it affects the work of the immune system cells, according to American doctors. White blood cells of singles are more prone to inflammation and less responsive to viruses. Moreover, this effect intensifies with time, the longer the loneliness, the more pronounced these disorders are. It's contagious. Scientists from Brigham Young University predict that in the coming years, humanity is waiting for a veritable epidemic of loneliness. And in the risk group of young people, for whom the probability of premature death from stress associated with social isolation, much higher than for the elderly. The authors of the work note that people who live in families and have many friends are increasingly feeling lonely. According to John Cacioppo, this may be due to the fact that loneliness, like many other social phenomena, such as smoking, is a kind of contagious disease. Having analyzed with colleagues social connections in the American town of Framingham, the scientist came to the conclusion that lonely people prefer to communicate with their peers, which means that loneliness is a manifestation of copycat behavior. Statistics, based on data collected over 50 years, confirm this. Those who socialize with lonely people eventually begin to suffer from loneliness as well. The dangers of social isolation and its effects on health are greatly underestimated, University of Queensland researchers say. Only 15% of US and British citizens surveyed by scientists admitted that loneliness may be a significant factor in premature death. Meanwhile, loneliness kills more people a year than smoking, alcohol, and obesity, according to experts from the University of Minnesota. Women are weaker than men in many ways and oppressed by prolonged patriarchy, so for centuries they have developed their own tactics to fight for their interests. Feminine cunning. It differs from men's only by gender and the stereotypes associated with it, but otherwise it is the same poisonously cruel, mercenary, selfish, and cynical controlling influence on a person, of any gender. Usually any means are used, since women are only interested in their own personal material interests and those of their offspring. Morality is of no interest at all, which makes this method of pursuing one's especially disgusting. Especially disgusting is the fact that women inexperienced men are unpredictable, as well as intuitive cunning and trying to look kind, so you can identify a cunning woman only after she receives from you what she needs and leaves. If a woman uses her feminine guile, she does so knowingly and calculatingly, and therefore, legally speaking, she is to blame for it. Therefore, it would be fair to punish her in such a case, although the dirty hands on this creature few want to, which is insidious women are very happy. Conclusion. With women must be very careful, do not rely on them, do not expose them to the back, do not give reasons to be interested in what is yours by right, your material, in the first place, because that is what women love most in the world, and intangible values.